My age is written on the candle. It's only one. Make my wish, but I have no wish. Allah, I wish for you all. I didn't know there was so much joy and fun in having birthday. It is because of your joy I enjoy so much. Words are inadequate to express what I feel. I remember when I went to India in 1935 and 36. I remembered what Jesus said and why he said, "Who is my father, who is my mother, sister and brother, but who loves God?" And with great awe I felt all those of you whose life I have lived, each one of you, and the joy of your spiritual growth had been so impinged in my consciousness that I felt my real brothers and sisters are those who love God. Parents are given to us by God, and the real father is God, and the real mother is God, and real brothers and sisters are those who love God. So I remember that feeling, that indescribable feeling in India. And all those of you who have lived up to my ideals and whose lives I have lived in myself, I know each of you. And I know that you haven't deceived me in any way. You couldn't if you tried, but I was within you. And I never have deceived any of you in word, speech, or mind. That's why the God in us became manifest and we realize the joy of living in a spiritual family where God is the father and the mother and we are his children. So this birthday is very significant to me. Though my body was born in the womb of a very divine mother, I was born in your heart, through the heart of God. I never dreamt that such a fellow feeling would be possible, and it is because you have lived up to the ideals that I have cherished, the ideals which I cherished and lived for in the company of my great guru preceptor. So I am very, very fortunate to realize in this world that though loving my relatives truly and not limiting my love to them, I realize the greater love of God. For it is God who comes as the father and the mother and the brother and the sister, the husband and the wife and the children. We must not stop there. Why is it that two people, they marry, they have children, they have a family, then they are thrown apart? To grow the divine love. And we must not stop there. We must invest that love in the world. When we can make others our own, and you can't make others your own by any form of diplomacy. It is by the sincerity of your heart. As you know, relatives are imposed upon us and we have to keep them if they are bad. But our spiritual relatives we can choose. And love and friendship can be only received as gifts. God comes to us as relatives to test us, but he comes to us as friends to give himself unto us. For in friendship, wherein we elect each other by the gift of free choice of our hearts, we find the glory of God manifest. And never have I felt such a felt feeling in the spiritual family in which I was born as I feel in this divine family. Here we have never asked who followed the Jewish religion or Christian religion or the Hindu religion. We have taken you all as you know, because you love God. And that's why this birthday is very significant to me, because I was born in this family, this eternal family. I was born in your hearts. And that's why it gives me an indescribable joy, joy for the virtue of God in this family, for the God who is invisible and unseen. And while the audacity of the seen world eclipses the glory and the love of God, when we bring that invisible and the unseen power and make Him manifest in our daily life, then He appreciates us. For God has everything, but He hasn't all that. He created us with one expectation. Perchance we would use our free choice to love Him in preference to His gifts. That's why Jesus said, "Let the men of the world seek after gifts of God, the short-sighted people of the world seek after. But ye who are wise, ye who love God, love the giver of all gifts, and all things will be added unto you. For all things belong to Him, including our bodies. Nor ye be of doubtful